Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sharif and today we are going to learn how to calculate reactions for such beam under concentrated loads and then draw shear and bending moment diagram in an easy way and a fast and effective way. So let's start by calculating reactions. As you can see, for that beam we have roller support at A, so we have only one reaction, which is called YA. And we have a pin support at B. So at pin support, we have two reactions, X at B, and then we have also Y at B. So using the three equilibrium equation, we can find these unknowns. And to do that, we can start by the force in X. So summation of Fx equals to zero. Okay. Therefore, we don't have any X force here. All these forces are vertical forces, therefore the X at B equals zero. So X at B equals zero, and this will be our first unknown. We got it, it is zero. Then we need to find the other two unknowns, Y at A or Y at B. So we can take a moment at one of them to eliminate this one, and we can get the YA. So I'm going to take the moment at B, so let's do that. Then summation of M at B equals zero. Okay, I will assume counterclockwise is a positive, therefore we have four, which is this force here, times the whole distance. This distance is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1.5, so this is 7.5. so 4 times 7.5 plus this 10 times the distance, so 10 times 3.5 plus 8 times 1.5 minus YA, which is this one. This will give us a clockwise rotation, so it will be in minus. So minus YA times this distance, which is 5.5. so minus YA times 5.5 equals zero. And from here, using your calculator, we can calculate the value of Y at A. This value will be 14 kilonewton going upward, and this will be our second unknown. Then this Y at A equals 14 kilonewton. X at B is zero, so the only remaining force is the Y at B. To do that, we can take summation of forces in Y direction equals to zero, assuming going up is positive, and therefore we have 4 going down, 10 and 8. All of this will be like 18 plus 4 equals 22, so we can do that. Minus 4 minus 10 minus 8 plus the reactions that we already got, which was Y at A, so plus 14 plus Y at B equals to zero. And therefore, using your calculator, we can calculate Y at B equals, let's do that, so it will be 8 kilonewton going up. And to check your answer, you should take a moment at any other point that you didn't use before to ensure that your reactions are fine. So to do that, I'm going to make a check. I will take a moment at this point, whatever at the end here, I will call it, this is A, B, C, D, let's say point at E, and check set submission of M at E equals 2. Okay, assuming counterclockwise is positive. So taking a moment here, this force will be eliminated. Then we are going to start YA times 2. This is counterclockwise, it is positive. So it will be 14 times 2 minus 10 times 4 meters minus 8 times this distance. This is the 8 and the distance is 6 meters plus YB times the whole distance, which is 7.5. So plus YB, YB already we calculated is 8 kilonewton. So this is 8 kilonewton times 7.5, and let's use our calculator to ensure these are equal to zero. So 14 times 2 minus 10 times 4 minus 8 times 6 plus 8 times 7.5, this equals to zero. It means we are okay about reactions. So the reactions are fine. Now we will come to the drawing shear and moment diagram. For drawing shear, it is just you follow the load, start from left side and just follow the load. Going down is negative, going up is positive. And as you know, like the shear, if it is going from left, it is, or up, or from left up or right down, this is like a positive shear, and opposite will be a negative shear. For bending moment, okay, if the moment is going up from left or right, so this will be like a positive moment. So this is a sign convention of the moment and shear force diagrams. Therefore, let's follow this. For shear, it is always the best way to do it, to start from the left side. And if you are going up, it will be a positive shear. So we will follow from the left side. We have 4 is going down. So this means a negative. So we'll go down here, negative. And the value here is minus 4. Then you don't have any load here. So if you don't have any load, we go parallel to the beam. Okay, so from here, we will go parallel to the beam. Minus 4 will continue like that. Then at this point, what we will find? We will find a concentrated load. 14 will take up us. So with this 14, we will go up. So 14 minus 4, it will give us a value of 10 at this point. Then let's continue again parallel. Then we have this 10 will take us down. So 10 minus 10 equal to 0. We will go back to 0 here. And from this point to that point, nothing. So we will go horizontal. And then we have this 8 will take us down again. So we just follow. So let's go down again with a value of 8. So it will be something like that. And the value here, it will be minus 8. Then going again from this point, from 8 to YB, there is no load. So it will be horizontal or parallel to the beam. So we'll go like that. And then we will find at the end this 8 is going upward, so it will take us again to 0, as you can see here. So we start from 0 and we end by 0, and therefore this one will be like a negative shear, this will be a positive shear, and this will be again a negative shear. So we start from 0, following the load, going 4 horizontal, then 14 will take us up, then horizontal, then 10 will take us down, then horizontal, and minus 8, and then the 8 at the end will take us again to the 0, and this will be the shape of the shear force diagram. Now for the bending moment diagram, this is the shear. And now for the moment diagram, I will draw the moment diagram. Negative is up and positive is down. Some schoolers, they used to draw the negative moment is down and positive moment is up, as in the case of the shear. But some other schoolers, they draw the positive moment down and negative moment up. This will ensure that the moment will be drawn at the tension side. We draw the moment at the tension side. To do that, we should draw the positive moment down and the negative moment up. And also, this will be like easy to draw because it will be similar to the deflection. So to draw the moment, let's see how to draw the moment. First of all, you should know like important points where you need to know the moment at this point. So we need to get the moment at the beginning of the beam, at the support at under any concentrated loads, and also at the end of the beam. So we have 5 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, at the beginning, we know that at this point here at E, end of the beam, no external moment. So the moment at this point equals to zero. So you should know that the moment here will be zero and it will not change again. Let's go back, it will be zero. And at end pin or roller support, as in case of B here, also end pin or roller support, the moment will be zero. So the moment here again will be a zero. So zero and zero, you know, 2 points. What we need to find now, we need to find the moment at C. Okay, you have two options to do that. Okay, we can get it from the shear. So it will be the area, the moment here, the change in the moment between this point, from this point to that point. Okay, it will be the area of the shear. So the area of the shear force diagram, which is this one, it is minus 4 times 2. So it will be minus 8. So for minus, I will draw it here up, and the value here, it will be -8. Okay, another way to do that, just you can take a section at this point here and take a moment from left side. So the moment at C equals what? 4 going down times 2. So it will be a moment like that, which is opposite to this, so it would be negative moment. So 4 times 2 going down, this will be a negative moment because it is opposite to our case here. So it is a negative moment, equals also -8, because -4 times 2 equals -8. So we reach the same value that we have it from the shear. So you can get it from shear if you have the shear is there, and if you don't have the shear force diagram, you can get it by taking a section at this point, and it will be the force times distance. And if you are following this, it's going up, it is positive, or going down, it is negative. So in this case, it is negative. Therefore, we got the moment at this point, -8. We need also to get the moment at this point here. How to get the moment here? Just by taking a section and calculating the moment from the right side. So the moment at this point equals what? Equals YB times 1.5. YB, which is 8 times 1.5, this will give us a positive 12, because the moment will be going up like that. So 8 times 1.5 going up, so the moment here will be 12 positive moment. So 12 positive moment, I will draw the positive down, or always at the tail side. This is the tail side, this is the moment and the tail side, so it will be positive 12. So I will have it somewhere here, and this will be positive 12. Okay, where else I need to find? We need to find the moment at the position of this concentrated load. How to do that? We take a section here and we take a moment from right side or from left side, as you like. Which one is easier, you can do it. If we take the moment here from the right side, how much it will be the moment? We'll say M equals how much? 8 times 3.5. This is positive. 8 times 3.5 going up, it is positive, minus this 8 times 2, and it will be negative. So minus 8 times 2, this will give a value of, let's see, 8 times 3.5 minus 8 times 2 equals 12 also. So the moment at this point, again, also it is 12. So we got the moment at 4 points. At this point, it is zero, and it's zero. You know this from the beginning. At this point, you can get it from shear, or you can take it by section. And then at this point also, you can get it by section, or even if you want, you can take it by from the shear, and the same here. So the last step is just to connect these points together. If you have a concentrated load, no uniform load, so all of these will be linear. We know that if the shear is horizontal, the moment will be linear. Okay, so if we have concentrated load, the shear will be linear, and then the moment will be the shear will be horizontal, and the moment will be linear. If we started by a horizontal force, the shear will be linear, and the moment will be a curve. So in this case, we started by concentrated load, so we have constant shear values, and then the moment will be linear. Okay, so no uniform load, no curves, only linear. So the last step to do is just to connect these points together. Okay, here, here, this one, and this one. And this will be the bending moment diagram. Above the line will be negative, under the line here will be positive. I hope that this is useful, and if you like it, just follow me and see the coming videos.